a bit much,
aren't it they?
You're presenting.
Yeah. Priapic. Yeah, no. A little bit much, so I'll apologise for that now.
That's okay.
You guys are dressed so well today.
No, that's...
you can usually see mine through the tweed.
I try and go... You could
have
almost,
you got protectors? Well,
mine are pierced.
Right, okay.
I usually go with a very subtle titty ring. And
this is encompasses in circles your stomach like a Venn diagram.
Yeah.
So large.
They do, they crisscross. and in the middle, it's all
welded
brown.
Together.
Cameraman thinks you're serious.
Cameraman knows I'm serious.
He's got that look in his eye.
Yeah.
Are we on? Oh, we're on. Good. guys, welcome to the show. You are dressed impeccably. We were talking off camera about my prominent nipples, and I apologise for those straight away. You enjoying London? You enjoying the London fog?
It is the quintessential London fog today.
Mm.
It's beautiful.
It's a pea super.
I love it.
Yeah.
I wish I'd had a camera this morning. I was up at 6 and... People
did you go for a stroll? Did you go for a stroll?
No, I actually went to do a morning show. And
oh,
so
right,
on
okay.
the way over, so many great images of London. I wish I'd had a camera with
you. Did you head over a bridge at any point?
I did.
That's always great in fog, isn't it?
Yes. Beautiful.
Guys, when you did the first Anchorman film, did you kind of ever think that it would achieve such penetration, so to speak?
No. I mean, we never thought about it. I mean, we thought, oh, I hope people like this.
Mm.
But it wasn't... It didn't happen right away.
Mm.
I mean, over the years, I think people, they started playing this on television a lot and DVDs and all of that, and it started to gain in popularity. But when it came out, it wasn't a big old hit.
Mm. When you're sort of strolling around town, possibly through fog, possibly not, you know, do people chuck one particular catchphrase at you? Is that?
Do people really like it that much, or is it like 10 or 15 people who are just really vocal
loud
about it?
Really,
and it's
loud
the same
it.
People who say, I love Lamp!
Right, okay,
and over. I don't know if it's everybody, but I think there is a very diehard group of people who really enjoy the movie.
Because what I like about the second one is that you could have just rehashed it. You could have just played lip service to the fan service effectively and just done it over and over again. But this is a true continuation of the actual story, isn't it?
Well, you know, I think when I read the script for the first one, I thought, this is the funniest script I've ever read, and it's so unlike a studio comedy, or like, and that's why no one would finance it. No one would make it. It was so bold and weird, and that caught on over the years. And I think that's because it's inherent in Will Ferrell and Adam McKay to go in a very weird direction. Mm. So, with this one, I don't think they would have ever had it in them, just inherently in who they are, to just rehash and go for a standard sequel. It's like, this could just fail, but let's make it weirder and...
No, it's true. They wouldn't have done it had it been that.
Yeah.
Had it been just a rehash.
With projects like this, do you guys get bored with the same old script being sent to your door? You know,
I've never been more excited to read anything than this one.
Mm.
And it took a while. We were all on board, and we were doing it before there was even a script.
I read that all you guys during filming had to get home at some point, and you all ended up, pretty much the whole main five cast members ended up at one airport at the same time, and people were just looking at you going, what, is this a stunt? Is this what?
We just all found that we were on the same flight heading back.
Yeah.
And we stopped and had a nice lunch at Chili's.
Yeah.
And did you have the jalapeno poppers?
I think I got the jalapeno poppers, and maybe did you get a spinach dip?
I had the spin dip.
Mm.
And
it was delicious.
Yeah.
And then
the three of us were walking to the gate, and Will just out of nowhere appeared and joined us, like almost out of a cloud of fog. He just sort of appeared. So the four of us were walking to the gate together. And it was kind of a monumental moment. Yeah.
Guys, thank you so much for talking to us. Have a really good premiere and an even better year.
Thank you very much. You.